South Korea scrambles fighter jets after Chinese and Russian warplanes reportedly entered its air defense zone without notice. Seoul's military said Chinese H-6 bombers entered the zone early Wednesday near its southern and northeastern coasts. They returned to the area hours after, this time accompanied by six Russian warplanes. Japan's military also says it readied its jets after the Chinese planes flew over the Sea of Japan. South Korea's Yonhap News Agency reported Beijing and Moscow appeared to have engaged in a joint air exercise, citing unnamed observers. The incident comes amid North Korea's record-breaking blitz of missile launches over the Korean Peninsula. China and Russia are both allies of the North and have vetoed a U.S.-led effort to tighten sanctions on Pyongyang in response to those launches. In other news, Filipinos lured by a syndicate running a cryptocurrency scam in Myanmar share details of a harrowing ordeal. Zen Hernandez has this story.
This is where a number of Filipinos who were promised work in Thailand ended up. A building in Myanmar, which they reached after 8 hours of land travel from the airport in Bangkok and a short boat ride across a river at the border of Thailand and Myanmar. According to one worker, armed men deliver them to this place.
Doon po kami natakot kasi pagbaba po sa amin doon sa masukal na parang gubat po. May dalawang armado pong lalaki na may dala nga pong baril. Tapos nung pababa po kami sa ilog, bawal magsalita, bawal magingay. Tapos sumakay na kami sa bangka. Pag-angat po namin ng river, mga nasa 20 to 30 po nakataon na civilian na may hawak na armalite yung sumalubog sa amin.
Stella's nightmare began after she responded to a job posting for call center agents on Facebook, promising 5,000 Chinese yuan or around 40,000 in Philippine pesos per month. The job turns out to be illegal, as they were ordered to lure people to invest in cryptocurrency. Stella said they were made to create fake profiles on networking sites LinkedIn and Tinder, build friendly or romantic relationships with targets whom they refer to as clients, and eventually message them through messaging apps like WhatsApp or Telegram. The victims will be made to earn at first, but their accounts will be frozen later on. Stella says they were required to get at least 3 clients a day and secure $1,000 in investments per week. Those who miss the mark face penalties, ranging from death threats to actual physical harm.
Sumahod po kami ng 2 buwan po, pero kinukuha din po nila kasi po pag wala ka pong nape-perform, magpe-penalty ka po. Nagpa-fine po kami. Tapos pag di po kami nag-fine, sasaktan kami. Corporal punishment, nilalatigo, electric baton. Yung hindi mo alam pagpasok mo kung papatayin ka na ba. Kasi lahat po ng pagbabanta.
According to information gathered by Senator Ontiveros, a big syndicate is behind the large-scale scamming operations in the so-called scam city of Myanmar. The Department of Migrant Workers also discovered similar operations in countries like Cambodia and Laos.
Not just Myanmar, now we are also looking at Cambodia and Laos. In fact, the POEA has issued an advisory cautioning our OFWs, especially the job applicants, against this online recruitment for our workers to illegally go and be employed in the so-called crypto techno parks in very remote areas in Cambodia, Laos, and Myanmar.
Senator Riza Ontiveros suspects individuals from the Bureau of Immigration and Manila International Airport Authority could be involved in the smuggling of Filipinos. Both agencies are now conducting separate investigations.
For them to facilitate this kind of modus, talagang medyo malalim, and of course they have knowledge about the systems inside our airports. I'm trying to get the information kung saan niya nakuha itong ganitong ID, sino po ang nagbigay sa kanya, at of course the change in hands in terms of the transactions.
Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.